So my name is Rajeshwari Yogi. You can call me Raji. And I studied master's program in wireless communication. I started working at Ericsson in January 2019, so soon it will be 5 years. And now I'm working as RFIC validation lead for one of the millimeter wave projects here at Ericsson. So I applied for master's program in wireless communication because in India I was doing a five-year dual degree course of engineering in telecommunication and MBA in finance. And during my bachelor's thesis, I got opportunity to do my thesis work at ESS here. And after that amazing experience, I didn't want to go back to the finance domain. So I wanted to continue in the technical domain. So the program is really well structured with the possibility to choose multiple electives, which were also very well aligned in which direction I wanted to go. Also, Lund University has really good ranking and LTH is so close to like big major companies here and also a lot of startups. Plus, I mean, the program is arranged in a way that it gives really good theoretical knowledge base, but also there are so many labs involved, so you get really good hands-on experience with the instruments, with actually implementing your theoretical knowledge base, which I liked a lot. So Ericsson is like a world leader when it comes to 5G infrastructure providers. So it gives us a really good opportunity to work with the cutting edge technology. And before I joined Ericsson, I had an opportunity to visit the lab that we have here at Ericsson. And I was super impressed by the setups that we have, measurement instruments that we have, OTA chambers that we have. So it was really obvious choice. And the thing that I like most about my job is that there is always new things to learn about. So you're always building up your knowledge base. You're always expanding your skills. And being surrounded by talented and helpful colleagues makes like everyday work really fun. So there are many things that I learned during my master's program at LTH that I use in my daily work here. For example, the RF fundamental principles like measuring S parameters, designing matching networks, working with VNAs, those form the base of my work or the daily work that I do here. So of course you have to build up on the concepts that you have learned, but once you have a strong fundamental base, then it becomes easier to progress quickly. And also in addition to the technical aspect, I got a number of extracurricular opportunities that I could contribute with. For example, working as SI leader or contributing as student mentor, being program ambassador for wireless communication, receiving this Global Swede Award. And all this contributes a lot in building your interpersonal skills. So you get opportunity to interact with so many different students, different people who are coming from very different cultural backgrounds, have very different knowledge base, technical background. And then you learn a lot to first actively listen to them, understand different perspectives, foster good constructive discussions. And I think these skills, in addition to your technical knowledge, contributes a lot to build you as a person as well.